I guess I should start now. Expo is a framework for universal React apps. So first we'll be discussing about Expo. Expo is a framework for universal React applications. It's free open source tool built around React Native, used to build iOS and Android projects using JavaScript and React. Okay, so using Expo, we can easily create iOS as well as Android projects by simply writing a JavaScript code, and it's an open source tool using which we can create React native apps. What are native apps? So I'll be telling you about native apps. Native apps are nothing but a software programs that is specifically that is developed for specific devices or like specific platforms that can be Android or iOS or any platform devices. Okay, so what are the benefits that Expo gave us rather than React Native app? It enables us to use third-party app components to build our applications. So it provides us some of the tools and APIs using which we can use in our project to build our project, and that's it. So some of the Expo tools which we can use to build Expo apps are first is Expo CLI. It's a command line interface for Expo, and it provides all the power of GUI based XDE. So XDE is our Expo development tool. All the development environment power of XDE is provided to us by Expo CLI. And what is XDE? XDE is an Expo development tool, a GUI for setting up your Expo development, your bundle logs and deploying updates. You can even run your app on iOS simulator or your Android emulator, or even your Android device using XDE. What is Expo client? It's an app for Android or iOS which you can easily download from your Play Store or App Store. It helps you test your mobile phones simply by scanning the QR code that's given in the XDE. And Expo Snack is a web app that helps working our application in the browser with the live preview of our code. It's nothing but an online IDE to run your Expo code. What is Expo SDK? It's a collection of JavaScript APIs that provides extra functionality to our apps. So it's nothing but a set of functionalities that are not present in our base React Native base React Native package. These SDKs may include many APIs like API for camera, for notification, or for accelerometer, there are many APIs which are present in Expo SDK which we can use in our project. So these are some of the features of Expo, or these are some of the APIs which Expo provides us. So some of them are accelerometer access. You can easily access the device accelerometer sensors to respond to change in device motion. You can use social authentication. You can use camera APIs, file system APIs. You can even use location APIs, image picker, or you can use contacts and Google Maps. There are many different APIs many different APIs which are provided to us by Expo, which you can easily install in your Expo project, and you can easily run those APIs. So these are the steps to install your Expo project. The prerequisite to install your Expo project is, first you will be needing Node.js. You can easily install it using Brew install node, or you could, for Ubuntu users, you can use apt install node. Okay, and then you will be simply by typing npm install expo cli, you can easily install expo cli in your terminal. And to create your project, you just have to write expo init and your project name, whatever you want to give name to your project. You have to visit that project, and then you just have to write the command expo stat, and your project will start running. So I'll give you a preview of that afterwards. Okay, so this is a project structure which you will see when you will build your, you will create your project. Okay, there's an assets folder which will contain all your images, video files and songs. Whatever media files are there, you can keep that in assets folder. And there is this app.js file. It's a basic React Native component. Whatever you write in this file, that will be displayed in your application. App.json contains the details about your project, what is the name, version, or everything about your project that's there in app.json. In package.json, there will be information about all the dependencies which you have included in your project. And that's the basic project structure of Expo project. And this is a small example of Hello World which we have written in app.js file. Okay, on the top we have imported React component, and then we have imported some of the React Native components like style sheet, text, and view. These components, text, view, are like our HTML components. Okay, so view is just like the div component which we div tag which we use in our HTML, and text is simply used to display a text on our screen. So in React Native app, we don't have HTML elements like div, paragraph tag, or anchor tag. We have to use built-in components provided to us by React Native. So those components only we can use. By default, React Native uses function component, as it is simple and lightweight as compared to the classes. You can also build use class components, but it will make your project slightly slower rather than using function component. You should use function components as it is much lightweight. And then you have you in this we have returned view in return statement. In return function we have used view. Style is nothing but in styles we are referencing styles container object. Okay, constant styles is equal to style sheet dot create is nothing but a JavaScript object that we have referenced in our style which we have used in view. These are not the CSS properties but JavaScript attributes which we have used. We could have simply used these attributes in our style, but the reason we have used style sheet dot create I'll tell you later. while giving you a demo. So rest I'll be discussing later. First I'll give you a demo of the project built by Expo. So you can simply, first you have to install your Node.js, and to create project you have to write Expo in it and whatever name you wanna give to your project, suppose my demo, and this. Okay, it will simply create, and then it will ask you about which workflow you wanna use to build your application. You could even use manage workflow or bare workflow. For I'll be using manage workflow. I haven't used bare workflow yet, so I'll be telling you about managed workflow, and it will start building. It's gonna take some time, so I'll be showing you the project which I have already created, and because it's gonna take some time, so I'll just stop it, I guess. Yeah, so when we build our app, this is the window which appear to us. App.js is our main file where we have to write all the code which will be displayed in our app. On the top we have imported react.js. whatever we write here is gonna display to us, and to start our application we have to write expo.start, or you can even write npm start. If you wanna run your app in Android emulator, you need Android Studio, and for iOS simulator you can use Xcode. So I'll be showing you on Android emulator, and this is Android Virtual Device Manager. I've already created
Am I audible?
So you can easily see what are the changes you have made. So it uses a component based structure in which you can easily okay. So you can create different components and then integrate those components to create your application. So I have created some of the these components. So one of this is image component. You can easily import that component, this component, and you can use this component like this image. And if you are using any media image or video or any songs which are there in your project only, you can simply use require function and then give path of that media file or anything. Okay, and if you are like using some URL or something, you have to use URI, and along with that you have to give the width of and height of that image, because if you won't give the height and width of that component, that then it will not be visible, because by default it doesn't allow the image to display if there is no width and height given. So you have to provide it, and you can simply import that component in your app.js. Import images. Can't find variable images. I guess image is okay. See, yeah, you can see the image component, and if you wanna use button components, you just have to write button. You have to give title of that button, and you have to give on press event, and there are many other components like alert. You can simply write alert and any message you can give. First we have to include this component. this background images dot x, you can easily add background images to your native app by simply using image background component. You have to give style, you can give styles sources from where you have taken that background image. I have mentioned it and I have stored an assets folder, so I have given the path of assets folder here, and you can use whatever component you want to use within these brackets that will be displayed over your background image. So I have called button example images and text. You can easily see the background image button, and if I click on button component, I'll see this is alert which I've written here, and you can also use alert component, which allows us to customize our alert dialog. Because earlier you can see the title is alert and we are getting this message. You can also customize this by using alert component dot alert. The first thing is the title. The second is the message which we are gonna display on it. And then these are the array of buttons which we can add in our dialog. So if we click on this, you can see the title is testing, this is a message, and if you press yes, you can see the result in our console, press yes, and if you press no, then press no will be printed in your console. So these are some of the components which we can use. There is camera also. You can this is an external API of Expo, the extra functionality other than the base package which we can include in our Expo app. Simply by including this Expo camera, we have to also install it using Expo command. And to use this app, we set the state of permission to null, and then we have by default we have set the camera to back, that will be our rear camera, and then we have used effect. We have asked for the permission from the user. If he grants the permission to use the camera, then our camera will be open. If it's false, then there will be no access to the camera, and if he presses at back, then there will be no permission and there will be a blank screen there. So if we use this component, I guess I won't be able to show you this because this API doesn't work on emulator or simulator. Wait, let me see. This API doesn't work. You can see these are the APIs which Expo SDK providers. Which we can include in our project to use, and you can even check the properties of the APIs which you are gonna use and its compatibility on this site docs.expo.io, and in API reference you can easily see this is a way to install this API, Expo install Expo camera, and there's an example for this. For every API there's an example given. You can easily check the compatibility of that API, and you can use it accordingly in your project. So you can see you can't use it in Android emulator or iOS simulator, so I won't be able to show you that. If this works, yes, it works. And this is the Expo Snack, the tool which I was talking about. It's basically a web ID for Expo apps or React Native apps. You can I guess this won't work either, because I'll be needing an account for that and I don't have it right now. So, but or she can see it on your mobile phones. Let me see if I can show you on my mobile. You can see the Expo app. Okay, and yes, it works. Yes. Wait. So you can easily see this camera API works. Fine. So similarly, like
this API you can use many different APIs available to us by Expo SDK. There are many of these APIs you can use it for extra functionality. So that's it. And now we'll be discussing. So there are basically two workflows, two approaches to build your Expo app. First is manage workflow. Expo tries to manage as much of the complexity of building app that you for you as we can, which is why we call it manage workflow. So in this we don't have to do anything. Expo will manage all the complexity. It will manage, we just have to write a JavaScript code to build our application and how it will connect it to the iOS app or how it will display to the Android view. Everything will be managed by Expo. We don't have to do anything. We don't have to write any configuration for our Android application or for our iOS. We just have to write the iOS. We just have to write our JavaScript code. Whereas in Bear workflow, in this approach, developers have full control over the app. If experienced in mobile development, then you can go for this approach as it is much complex as compared to managed workflow. So in this approach, it's almost similar to creating a project using your React Native CLI, in which there is Android and iOS folder in which the developer can add his or her React Native code for which he could have written in Java, C, C++ or anything, or any configurations for his Android app or iOS app. He could easily insert in that. So it's similar to that. We can customize our Expo app using native libraries or our own libraries, whereas in manage workflow we have to use the functionalities provided to us by Expo. We can't use our customized functionalities, or we can't write our own functionalities. We have to depend on the functionalities given to us by Expo. So that's one of a disadvantage of managed workflows. Whereas in Bear workflow, it's like we are given a plain vanilla React Native app, and we are using some of the Expo modules in that. It's simply like that. And some of the pros of using Expo app is, as you can see, setting up of project is very fast and simple. You can open the app while you are working on it. You can easily check the changes you have made at the time of like if you are making any changes in your project, you can easily check on your app, and you can easily share your app via link or QR code. There is no need to build the app to run it. You can always eject your app to Expo Kit and integrate it to the native code. That's a major advantage which we can use, because since we are limited to the functionalities provided to us by Expo, so if we wanna switch to React app or like we wanna go for it, we can easily eject from it and we can move in that. So you can easily build your application. What are the cons of it? You can't use native modules or libraries that uses native code built in C or Java or any other language, but in bare workflow you can use it, because it's just bare workflow was introduced in, I guess, 2019. It's recent only, they have started this thing. So I guess it's, if you use bare workflow you can use some of your native code, but whereas if you use manage workflow you can't use it, you have to depend on Expo functionalities only. So since we are using Expo SDK components, and all the modules there in the SDK components are used, so size of the application is much larger, and ejecting to Expo Kit is a bit challenge because of some reasons. These are that you can't share your app file link or QR code, or some dependencies might also not work, so this can be a major problem. Even debugging in Expo Kit is a complication. So these are some of the challenges of ejecting to Expo Kit, and we are also limited to the API supported by Expo, and these are some of the references. And I forgot to tell you about like debugging and logging also. So you can easily check your logs here in the terminal, and also in the XGE you can easily see the log bundler. And you can if you want to debug your app, if suppose you have started it, allow this. By pressing Command M you can see this. You have to press debug remote.js and this window will appear, and you can easily open your developer mode, and you can just debug it like you normally do to your web applications. That's how you can debug your app. So that it's one of the advantage of Expo, that we can, it provides us easy debugging, so you can easily debug your app also. So yes, these are some of the advantages of Expo, but also there are some disadvantages too. If you are new to Android or like iOS and you don't have any prior knowledge to mobile development, so you can go for it, as it provides many functionalities which we can easily include in our projects. And yes, if before building your app, if you want to go for Expo, you must check these sites and confirm whether the requirements of your applications are met by Expo or not. You can visit expo.canny.io and you can check the API's progress, or what are the features they are gonna add, or they have already added, or which are in progress which could be used in your project. You can always refer docs.expo.io for all the APIs. You can even check how it works, and you can simply use them in your applications, as well as for more information you can see Expo documentations. And that's it from my side. If you have any questions, you can write in the comment section.
हेलो हेलो So I guess that's it from my side. Thank you everyone for watching.